himself up. Andre Mill says, I'm transphobic.
Okay.
So there we go. That's a transphobic comment.
Fire. So everybody knows that Andre's Mill.
You don't even need to come up with a clever thing to say. You just need to say, I'm transphobic. That's all we actually need to say.
Amazing. Good to know. Hey everybody, I am Fox Fisher, and this is...
Lewis Hancock.
And we're back, we're doing videos.
We've not done this in a while. Well,
yes,
I have not.
Yes.
I've not been.
God, it's so awkward, isn't it?
Well, we should just say that we run my Genderation. Okay, yeah, part, cool. You know, just all right, cool. What we're doing. Just say what we're doing.
Okay, so today we're going to be having a look at some of the many comments that we get on my Genderation, because it is pretty epic. We receive a lot of negative comments from people. These keyboard warriors just love going in there and just telling us what they think of everything. So... yeah, this is an opportunity to just have a look at some, like probably 0.5% of the...
of the total negative comments that we get.
Yeah, probably just this year. So.
And trans stuff, like, you know, well, I don't know how much we're explained about my generation, but just in the media right now, there's so much negative press about trans people, right?
Yeah.
Right. Sorry, but we've got a little cat here that's creating some rustling.
A little rag doll.
A little rag doll. Evie, come here.
Evie, weenie, come. Anyway, so...
here we go. But basically, there's just so much negative press right now, right? And it's really, like, just adding to the amount of... It's adding fuel to the fire, isn't it?
Yeah.
And there's online, and I never really experienced it in real life, but online, all these keyboard warriors...
They're pretty awful, nasty beings, because they go out of their way to tell us that we shouldn't have the right to exist. And huge warning in advance, if this kind of stuff does make you feel bad about yourself, I wouldn't watch this video, because we're going to be really delving into some negative comments. And the reason that we're doing that is so we can just have a quick response to it. Often we won't spend the time to reply individually to people that are abusing us. The best method, and I'd recommend this to anyone, is to screen grab and block and report this person. Because it's they're just not worth your time.
I'd just delete anything that's negative on videos, yeah, because I feel like if there's some negative comments there, it makes other people feel like they can add to that.
Exactly.
Whereas if it's all positive, like, you stand out like a sore thumb if you've commented something bad.
I hate the thought of somebody who's coming out as trans, or thinking they might be trans, or wanting to learn more about trans issues, and they go and check out the My Generation films, and then they see, you know, they see a beautiful film, but then they look at the comments, and they might get really, really put off with their own transition or someone else's transition, because...
You just expect that's how life's going to be, wouldn't you? You'd think, oh God, I'm going to transition and be bombarded by harassment.
Let's get into it, shall we? And this is just stuff at random. I'm just kind of going through the list.
I've not seen any of these. So
I know. Lucky you, Lewis. Lucky you. Okay, so the first one we have is from I Am They, which is a documentary that we put together. It's one of our first feature-length documentaries. Mm-hmm. It's about myself and my partner, Al, about us being non-binary. Mm-hmm. And somebody says, duh. Do you want to read it?
I have to read it. Okay, so they say, duh, y'all are trans. You are not non-binary. It's all fashion choices. You are not liberated if you don't choose something. I will never, and 99% of humanity will not call you them, this, that, or non-binary. Just stop. Right, so I had to get my head around that one. So they're saying to you and Al, you're trans and you're not non-binary.
And that it's all fashion choices that we're making.
Apparently. Yeah.
Okay, gosh, well, you know me.
Yeah, you're all about the fashion.
That's right, that's right. So, you know, Joanna, you're right. You're absolutely right.
You do love fashion. But non-binary isn't an outfit choice, is it?
No, non-binary.
Anyone can be non-binary.
Exactly. So if somebody identifies as non-binary, like I do, that's how I feel on the inside. How I express myself is a different thing. So I express myself in a pretty masculine way. Mm-hmm. You know, non-binary people don't exist in a vacuum. I mean, we live in a gendered world, so you're going to express yourself in a feminine way, a masculine way, or a combination of the two. So it's not up to you, Joanna, to decide whether I'm non-binary or not. I say I'm non-binary, so I am. I'm also trans, so you're half right, I guess.
Most people in society these days understand what it is to be a trans woman or a trans man. But what about trans people who don't identify with the rigid categories of being a man or a woman?
8 girls in her year are now non-binary, right? Mm-hmm. So schools are now running riot with kids
They're
who...
Not running riot.
Yes, they are running riot. When it's 8 kids in 1 year in one school in this country, it means it's now like a contagion.
I'm glad you think that I'm being very fashionable, but I'm also non-binary. I really, really am. So I don't need to prove myself to you. And apparently 99% of humanity will never call me them, this or that. That's not true either, because I am respected in my life.
And something a lot of people don't know is that saying they and them is something we do anyway. It's not a new... people say that it's a plural thing, right? And if you're saying them and they, that you're talking about more than one person. But actually, we do it all the time, don't we? If we don't know... Like you always say, if someone's called... And they say, well, someone's called for you, and you don't know who it is that's called. You say, oh, what did they say? Who are they? You know, you refer to someone as a gender-neutral thing.
Exactly.
You don't know male or female. So
that's totally true. And also, it's important to point out that non-binary people can use whatever pronouns they like. Just because somebody uses she pronouns doesn't mean that she's not non-binary. People often assume that non-binary people just use... they, them pronouns or a variation of that. That's just not the case. And in fact, my pronouns are he or they. So, ha, Johanna. We got an amazing series called Growing Older Is Me, and it's about older trans people that are living their lives. Some of them have come out a bit later in life. Some people came out a while ago, but they just want to share their story with us. It's a beautiful series. Recommend you check it out. And okay, here's a comment on Kat's video. And Kat is a pilot, a retired pilot for British Airways, still a pilot for smaller aircrafts.
So we'll show a little clip of that, won't
we? Totally, yeah.
I should have known that I was going to transition at the age of 14, but it was such a horrific prospect at the time. I looked like what I was, a 14-year-old rugby-playing schoolboy in a frock, and it just put me off completely. And I locked it away in a box marked Do Not Open.
So Smiley Face says...
Smiley Face says, it's a man still.
Right. Okay, so Kat is a
trans... Well, that's a typical transphobic comment, isn't it?
It
that
is.
People get, what trans women get.
It is, yeah. But, you know, obviously Kat is a trans woman. That means that she's a woman.
Mm-hmm. So, a woman still.
Yes, exactly. She's part of the woman category. And, you know, she is who she is. She's living her best life. So... you saying that she's a man still really doesn't change the fact that she's a trans woman, so that was a bit of a waste of time, don't you think?
Yes. Well, I just think that, like, people that made these comments, they're just missing the fundamental thing of what it is to be trans. Like, she is a woman, and yes, she was assigned male at birth and born into a body that might not feel quite right, but that is what makes her trans. Do you know what I mean?
Exactly.
Like, if she wasn't trans, yeah, she'd be a man still.
But
she'd be a man still, but she is trans, yeah. Exactly. Exactly.
Okay, so moving on. So we've got an amazing series called Trans And. It's a beautiful series. It's the first time we used our drone shots, which we really love. And it's a really intersectional series about people showing that we're more than just trans. We have a sexuality. We have all sorts of different aspects that make up who we are. So we've got a comment on just the trailer for Trans People Are More Than Just Trans. So somebody called Bria LaPont says...
Respect is a two-way street. People don't just get to be in your face and demand respect. Also, it is unhealthy to seek approval and validation from others.
Well, so are they calling them attention seekers, or what's
I think
the deal?
So. And saying that respect is a well, we've not disrespected you,
Bria.
No one's point. Disrespected you.
We
so.
Never came for you, Bria. Yeah. So why are you coming for us?
Exactly. Well. You're right, it does come down to respect, and that's the whole, that's literally, even if you don't understand what being trans is, surely it comes down to respect. You don't just say shit like that.
Yeah.
Because surely we all want to respect other humans, right?
Yeah, I'm sure.
I thought that was what we just all...
That's the aim of the game, isn't it? To be nice and kind and stuff, apparently not. So, and it's unhealthy to seek approval and validation from others. I think you're misunderstanding, Bria LaPoint. These people, you know, in the series, the trans and
misunderstanding
series,
LaPoint.
You're totally. Yeah, you've totally misunderstood LaPoint. Because all these people in the series, the trans and series, are just trying to live their best lives. Like, it doesn't affect you in any way at all. And it's just about people saying, hey, I really... I've really struggled, I've overcome this obstacle, I'm now who I am, and it's a continuing journey, but you know, these people are radically vulnerable, they're sharing their lives with you, and you turn around and say it's unhealthy to seek approval. They're not seeking your approval, Bria.
Yeah, yeah, and the only approval that we need to seek is kind of approval of, like, if we're going down the medical path, is, yeah, approval of doctors and things to get the treatment you need. That's the only approval on this journey you need to see.
And even that word approval, I mean, well, it should be something, right? Yeah, exactly. It should be something like, you know, seeking medical support, or,
yes,
you know.
Yeah, medical treatment, medical support, whatever.
Yeah, they should be there to assist us, really. So,
yeah.
Yeah, Bria, totally missed the point. Next lovely comment is from a short film that we made called Get Off My Turf, which we really enjoyed.
You yeah, it was, yeah, oh yeah, I always forget that I'm in it.
You played a bad boy.
I played a bad boy.
You know I stopped drinking and we broke up 3 months ago.
Come on, come on.
I want you to leave.
You can't fucking talk to me like that, who do you think you are?
Yeah.
And you played the
new love interest.
The love interest.
That's
yes.
Right. So it's a short film about a trans woman who lives next door to a transphobe, somebody who turns out to be quite transphobic, and it's about the relationship together as well as the relationship with the naughty ex.
Everyone acting in it was trans, right? So we weren't all right. Playing trans roles because we are just people.
Exactly. But we're really proud of it, you know, the fact that the whole cast. Trans. Yeah. Mm-hmm. All cast and crew, all trans. Very cool. Lisi.org says,
I thought the old woman was a dude.
Okay, so the old woman that they're referring to is probably the older person in the film who plays the neighbour, and that's our awesome friend Persia. Mm-hmm. And Persia is so funny and so clever and so talented. She's not a dude, I'm telling you now.
Well, they've kind of contradicted themselves anyway, because they're calling her a old woman. Not that that's a nice thing to be called, but yeah they're saying, yeah. Well,
so yeah, they're probably implying that.
I know.
Yeah, that Persia is, like the other person's comment, is a man still. Mm-hmm. It's a man still. You know, that's just like, what's the reason for doing that? One, you can't tell if someone's trans. Mm-hmm. And you know, Persia is an incredible being. She's overcome so many obstacles. It makes me so in awe that somebody can know that they're trans back in the day when there just wasn't YouTube or anything else available to them. Like, she's a hero, like, really. And mm-hmm. our trans elders are absolute legends, because they fought for greater rights, obviously, and, you know, mm-hmm. they knew who they were. So, yeah, good for them. So, no, that old woman is not a dude.
I don't know what else to say.
Nothing else to say. All right, so moving on. Okay, so we made a film. We've been actually filming with a trans boy called Kai since he was 9 years old. And Kai is now 16. Shout out to you, Kai, if you're watching. This is a film about when Kai was 14, and we're kind of doing a recap for the past 5 years. So at this point, we've been filming with Kai for 5 years. Kai is an incredible little dude. Like, I can't wait to see what Kai...
He's a good artist, isn't he? He's really good at art. Like, he's cool.
He's cool, he's confident, he's part of the new generation, and I can't wait to see what he does in life and how he thrives. He kind of went from wanting to be an ambulance driver to wanting to be a tattoo artist and so on. So yeah, we'll see what happens to Kai. So the comment about Kai says,
people need God.
So I think they're implying that we're like a godless bunch, that Kai is somehow removed from God. I think that ultimately living in your truth and being who you are is the ultimate existence. And I don't think that God, whatever phrase you want to use for a greater power, a higher being, or even our higher selves, would be against living in your truth. Right?
Yeah, and surely, you know, the far more important thing is to just treat people nicely, kindly, with respect. Surely God would want that. So God wouldn't approve of this
Madge's
comment. Do you know what I mean? And you can be trans and have God in your life. You know? You can be religious and trans. And...
Totally. I mean, there's vicars and priests who are trans people, just like there's trans people in all walks of life. Mm-hmm. So, you know, we're not godless. Thank you very much. We are very much so living in our truth.
And once you're able to live your truth, you're a nicer person. So you're, the happier you are, the nicer you end up treating others.
Exactly.
So we should be encouraged to live our truths, you know?
Yeah, because it's win-win, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, moving on. So we've been documenting Trans Pride in Brighton for, I think, the past 8 years. And, you know, it's such an incredible event. I was so proud to be able to help put on the first event. As I'm a co-founder of Trans Pride, and over the years we have, you know, just as volunteers, we haven't been paid for it, but we've gone out there and made sure that we've documented each and every event. For last year, well, this year obviously we couldn't have Trans Pride, we had a virtual Trans Pride, but last year was a major event where we used our drone for the first time. We got some incredible footage of the march, and yeah, we're just so proud of it. We've got a video about 2019's Trans Pride, and somebody says...
So which is the bad cut? It's both of them, okay.
Both.
Okay, so somebody says, guys, do you understand that some people are proud of being trans slash gay slash lesbian? This is how I, cisgender, will say, I am proud that I love women. This is nonsense. And yes, why is there an LGBT and the rest flag, but no straight flag? Why is there no straight parade? Why is there no cisgender month?
Do you want to handle this, Lewis? Let's ask why there's no cis pride and no straight month.
Because when you're born, everybody normally assumes that you are straight and cisgender, and everyone that isn't straight or cisgender does go through a battle with themselves to begin with, and then to the rest of the world to be accepted, right?
Totally. And also, how do you identify?
Me?
Are you straight?
I identify as a straight man, yes.
So would you like trans pride and straight pride?
I've never felt the need for a straight pride.
So of course trans people can have a sexuality or not, as the case may be.
But what did you tell me the other week? You said that you always say to people, well, actually... Was it you that said this?
I don't know.
Maybe it wasn't you.
Tell me.
Someone said to me, well, actually... They can't wait to say to people, there is actually an International Men's Day. There is actually an International Women's Day.
Yeah.
There are days that kind of... There's so many days, actually. Everyone will have a day. You just look... find your day.
Yeah. And if there isn't one, you can make one
make
day.
Make one up, yeah.
Make one straight day or cis day, whatever. We don't really care.
I don't care. If there was a straight day, it's not like I'd be opposed to it. I'd just be like, cool, there's a straight day.
As long as you don't use that day to shit on other people who aren't straight, aren't cis, like, go for it. That's fine.
Because I don't agree with using days about, you know, of trans events to shit on cisgender people. I'm sure there's shit people everywhere in the world, whether they're trans or not, right? So, you know, maybe...
There's shit people everywhere.
Can't swear, you'd have to bleep me out. There's crap people everywhere. There's nasty people everywhere, whether you're trans or not. So yes, some trans people might have been nasty to a cisgender person, be like, fuck cis people, right? The point is that most trans people aren't sort of against cis people, right? The way I see myself as part of cis people in my life. I just feel like we're all one, you know?
So why the divisions, you know? It's just so unnecessary. Yeah, to come on to our channel and just say all that stuff, I wonder how many other channels you've commented this rubbish to, because it doesn't even make sense. We made a film in Scotland a few years ago about trans healthcare, and we interviewed some amazing people up there, just talking about their experiences within the NHS and trying to navigate that for themselves, trying to access hormones and surgery and so on. And it was actually funded by the NHS, so they really wanted to know what was going on for people so that they could better what they were doing. So, you know, win-win all round, basically. So somebody says,
West End Stores discount says, why do you put yourselves through this torture? Is life not hard enough as it is? I think that is a good comment.
Right.
Right? Because, you know, it's obviously not meant to be good. But exactly, why would somebody put themselves through the torture of... You know, not that everyone has surgery, but, you know, just for example...
Yeah,
you
surgery know, is very invasive, costly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
My girlfriend looked after me. I had my lower surgery last year, and she looked after me, and she said, oh my God, she said, seeing you go through all this, she said, whenever anybody says anything negative to me about trans people now, she said, I just want to turn around and say, until you have seen somebody you care about go through such a massive ordeal just to feel themselves... You have no idea what it is to actually be trans.
Exactly.
And that, you know, nobody would choose this. And that's the point. It's not a choice. We're born trans, right? We don't choose.
Exactly. And being trans doesn't go away. You can try and push it down, squash it down. It rears its ugly head in various ways. I used to have panic attacks before I came out. Mm-hmm. And now I don't have panic attacks because I managed to sort out myself. Mm-hmm. So, You're right. Why would we put ourselves through this torture? We do it because it's an absolute necessity in order to live in this world. I recognize that I'm more than just my body. I am a multidimensional being having a human experience, but I really had to sort the vessel out in order to be more use on this planet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that makes sense. And actually, you know, the last part is not, is life not hard enough as it is? Life is hard before transitioning because even if we forgot what everyone else thought of us, we still have to live with our own head. The only thing we live with forever is ourselves. So that causes the biggest pain, right? The fact that our body doesn't align with how we feel. And so as soon as we correct that, actually, it makes every other aspect of life. It doesn't fix everything in life, but it makes life more livable.
Totally. 100%.
Yeah.
So we have another comment about Kai's film here. And Mount Shasta Videos says,
I personally don't think hormone blockers should be given to trans youth who have not gone through a full puberty. Well, that's the whole point of the hormone blockers is to...
to pause you puberty.
Yeah, you wouldn't have the hormone blockers if you've been through a puberty. Because going through puberty is the main event in a trans person's life that indicates they are actually trans. If they never go through that, they can't know for certain.
Okay, so let's break this down.
Yeah.
Like, when did you realise that you were trans? Because looking for me, looking back, it was so obvious. When I was 2, for example, I was a bridesmaid for my uncle's wedding, and I knew, I absolutely knew that the dress and the tights and the frills was just not for me. And I know that people can be tomboys, you know, it doesn't matter about clothing, but that was an indication. And then day in, day out from that point on, I was totally aware that I felt alien and different and that I didn't fit in. And pre-puberty, I was so happy when people saw me as a boy as well.
Yeah.
And that was an indication. So when, by the time the wrong puberty hit at age 10, 11, it was just awful. It was just the worst thing ever. And and if I'd had blockers at that point, I would have absolutely taken them.
Yeah. 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 Same. Just same. All I need to say.
Totally.
Just move on.
Fine, let's move on. This year, we released a film called Sorry Out of Gender. Shout out to Shanalika, who's an incredible YouTube creator as well. So we made this film called Sorry Out of Gender, and I think it's just a really catchy tune, and it was a music video full of non-binary people. And yeah, we just had a good time with it, and we got to film it at the Brighton Centre, and it was great. So Kai Lee says,
false victimhood and science denier.
Whoa, okay, so false victimhood. So first of all, there's no one who is claiming to be a victim in this film. Like, we're actually...
celebrating.
We're celebrating. We're really empowered with this film. And second of all, science denier. What are we denying about science? What are you talking about?
Well, science... people should know that science is nothing's straightforward in science, right? Everything's complicated.
Right.
And that's the same with gender and sex. And we've got so much proof that it's not black and white, physically and just from people's experiences. We've just got so much proof. We don't even need the proof, it just is, it just does exist, you know, the way, there's no, I don't know, what would be the...
Why would we deny science? If anything, I feel like science would help to explain why we're trans or that we're
exactly.
trans.
Exactly, there is lots of potential scientific explanations as to why we are the way we are.
Which is comforting, I think, in some ways.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
All right, so we're just going to do one more because I think that we've gone on for, you know, gone on for a little bit.
Why don't we do like three?
All right, we're going to do three more because we have an endless list of this and we will do another video like this in the future. So last three. Too long for us.
Look, I feel like you need to show a little bit of that to show what lengths this person's gone to.
Well, we've got this on record, so, you know, here's someone's comments that is just...
Well,
like...
there's no point reading it out, but someone's left this crazy essay of a comment.
Like, what?
What
this person is... oh, we know this person.
Oh my God, how do you know this person?
Well, this is Posey Parker. You know
the actual person, Posey Parker?
Yeah.
This is actually Posey
Kelly
Parker.
Kelly J. Keen Minshall, I think that's her name. Like, that's her actual name. So.
My mum is really knows about Posey Parker. She hates her.
She hates her. Yeah, well, everybody hates Posey Parker. So we made an incredible film a few years ago with Emma Franklin, who's an artist, trans woman, total legend. And the film's called Some Daddies Are Ladies, and it features Emma and her son.
They say, dad is male role. He have now mum. So some daddies are ladies is transphobic bullshit. So
okay, so I think it depends entirely on how Emma feels. So it's about Emma's decision. And if Emma wants to be a trans woman and have she, her pronouns and be called daddy, totally cool.
If her kid is used to calling her daddy and she doesn't want to like disrupt that, then what's the harm? Just let the kid, you know, if her kid knows that she's a she and a mum and a, well, not a mum, sorry, I'm getting confused. Put that bit out. You know, if, yeah, it's just if her child is comfortable, if that's something that they do, their little relationship is that her kid still calls her dad, it doesn't make her any less of a woman, it's just simply a word.
Exactly, so, and forcing her to be a mom instead of a dad, I wouldn't say that's transphobic, but I think that's a little bit, you know, why are you trying to enforce what you would do on someone else, you know?
That's a running theme through all the comments, isn't it? Why are these people trying to... Do you know what I mean, though? Like, what do they want us to all live by their rules and their life and just want to be a clone of
them? Yes,
them?
Lewis.
That's clear. Yeah, well, that's what they want. Okay.
Fair enough. Because they know best.
Well, yeah.
Right, okay, so this is one about you, Lewis. So Lewis made a video for the My Generation channel, which is called How Do You Have Sex? And how do you have sex as a trans
guy? As a trans guy.
Right. So King Rock says, why does he act so gay? Wait a second. So, first of all, gay people...
Well, there's a lot of points to address.
Yeah, okay, lots of points. So,
I know loads of straight people that you might think are gay. You know, that's wrong to assume, but I just mean... Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, exactly. No, absolutely right. So, and, you know, why King Rock, are you saying that Lewis is acting...
Well, I know that, like, I am quite camp and animated and stuff. That could be a number of reasons, right? Okay, it could be because I'm trans. It could be because I did have to try to fit in with females for a big chunk of my life, right? So I did really try to be the best girl I could be. And
I tried.
Exactly. We both tried. And so we actually, if you took any... guy that was actually even assigned female birth, if you took a cisgender guy and brought him up as a female, maybe. They probably might pick up some feminine traits, right? That's one. I'm not even saying that that's right to say that, but I just mean that there could be a reason as to why I'm a bit feminine.
But King Rock, I mean, this comment is really homophobic.
Well,
I mean,
yes, I know. I don't know. Maybe I don't even need to say that, but I'm just... My point is... Well, I feel like it's still a good point because I feel like it's, you know, it's society... Because that just shows it's society that has decided what's feminine and masculine, right?
Because
if I'd have just been allowed to just be me, I don't know, maybe I'd have turned... I would have probably turned out exactly the same because there is no right way to act. But if some of my feminine qualities are because I had to try to live as female for a while, that would be understandable too.
Yeah.
And there's nothing to be ashamed of with that. I'm just saying that...
Yeah, no, I think I know what you mean. Like, you know, because I was socialised as female and I had a lot of my friends are female. I think...
But it doesn't make us... Well, point is that it doesn't make us any less guys. We've been through that... Oh, well,
no, of course not. No, exactly.
We've been through an experience and we all come out different.
Sorry, it's just how we are. So, you know, get over it. Deal with your own internalised homophobia. Thank you. Okay, so moving on. Okay, so we did a film called What Haters Say About Trans People. And we made this quite a few years ago. It's like a comedy sketch. We play a couple of haters and we just talk about trans people. So Andres Mill says...
Well, I don't really need to say what... I don't know what the word is to describe this comment. It's just like it sums itself up. Andre Mill says, I'm transphobic.
Okay.
So there we go. That's a transphobic comment for
so
you.
Everybody knows that Andres Mill...
You don't even need to say, you don't even need to come up with a clever thing to say. You just need to say, I'm transphobic. That's all you actually need to say.
Amazing. Good to know. Thanks very much. We released a film recently called Walking Progress, which is a music video created by Rowan. And Rowan is an absolute legend. Used to do work experience for My Generation as well. We actually made another film about them. We actually made a film about them initially, where they were 19 and coming out as non-binary. We made it over the course of quite a few months because it features Rowan pre-surgery, pre-top surgery, and then Rowan post-top surgery doing a dance. So Striped Pot says...
Just a reminder, guy slash mate slash peeps. Gender is a biology thing, not a preference slash identity. You may call yourself whatever, but medically, you're biologically male slash female. It's important to tell your real gender slash tell your doc you're trans. Otherwise, complications may happen.
What do they mean by complications may happen?
If we didn't disclose to the doctor, if we pretended to doctors that we weren't trans, like born, you know, biologically, like, male, female, then...
Like you break your arm and you go in and...
I could pretend. I had my levels checked, my testosterone levels checked recently, and they actually put on the form a prostate, like they checked my prostate levels.
Oh, wow.
Well, obviously I don't have a prostate, but they came back perfectly normal.
Great.
So there it's we go. Right.
Yeah. So they're saying you need to disclose that you're trans.
Well, we're not trying to hide that we're trans, and we're not trying to fool anybody, and we're not trying to act as the, you know, they say you can act like a... Well, you know, what does that even mean? We're not trying to act as male. We're not trying to act as the opposite thing to what we are. We just are that thing.
When did we ever say that we were going to be pulling the wool over someone's eyes and pretending that we were cis males or whatever?
We're open about the fact we're trans,
yeah,
but it doesn't mean we're any less of men or people,
yeah,
humans,
exactly.
You know, or... It's just
we could show a clip of that, actually.
Okay, can I just say quickly?
Yeah.
I actually stumbled across a video recently. I don't like to focus on the science too much, but I just found this video quite validating, and it was a surgeon who runs a practice, and he specialises in transgender patients, and he was giving a lecture to other doctors and surgeons, and I just thought it was amazing because he goes into the scientific reasons as to why somebody could actually be trans, and there's so many different reasons... potential reasons, and he just says that trying to change somebody's psychology has been tried and tested. People have been subjected to mental hospitals, so much trauma, mm-hmm, trying to change how they are, and there is nothing that can change this. There's nothing other than changing our bodies to feel comfortable with how we are.
That's it. That's
and
the
that is
game.
Science. That's biology and science.
That's biology.
Yeah. So, I don't like that weird laugh.
Yeah.
No.
It's true. Okay, so we'll do one more just now. This is what non-binary looks like. It's a film that we made about being non-binary. It's a little bit arty. It's black and white, you know. And somebody called Don Clark says...
Male, female, those are the only two genders. Stop trying to invent new genders.
Okay, well, if you look at most indigenous cultures on the planet, you will see that there's been an acknowledgement of more than two genders. Two genders is very colonialistic. I mean, the UK, for example, and other countries too, took over other countries and took away whatever religion was going on there and whatever was happening, and enforced men and women and, you know, Christianity. And I think that, you know, we really need to step back a bit and just think about cultures that have existed for a really, really long time. It doesn't affect your identity as a man or a woman just because someone identifies as non-binary. Just get over it.
You're not saying that men and women don't exist by identifying as non-binary. You're saying that you don't...
It's acknowledging that people, not everyone fits within that, and, mm-hmm, you know, how we identify is really important. So, mm-hmm, yeah. Okay, so I guess that's probably it for now. That's the end of the evil comments.
There's lots more evil, but we'll get through that in another video.
Exactly, yeah. We hope you've enjoyed this video, and please don't forget to like and subscribe and comment so that we can give you more of these types of videos.
Yeah, and you should all comment positive comments below to counteract the evil comments. That's our little task for you. There's a prize for the most complimentary comments.
Ooh. It's exciting. What could it be?
I don't have a clue. What could it be?